Hi, I'm Dani and I'm back with another tutorial for you guys. Today, I'm gonna teach you how to edit like Ida Anduyan. If you don't know Ida, she's a Filipino fashion and lifestyle blogger and she's known for her unique style and carefully curated visual wonderland of a feed. You could generally describe it as muted pastels with pops of color. At least that's what I think. The thing with Ida though, and I think this is why I had a hard time picking what style I wanted to follow, is because I feel like you can break her style into three distinct types. So one is colorful, which we're gonna be focusing on today. The other is like a muted, dark type. And the other one is like a filmy, white, washed out pastels kind. I'll explain each one in three separate videos, but today we're gonna be focused on the first one, which is a very vibrant and warm summery look. For this, I'm going to be using her recent year photos as a basis. So for this look, you kind of have to have your content ready. Not gonna lie, it's gonna take a lot more effort than usual because you're only gonna wanna post and take photos of scenes with a lot of color. Your feed is only as good as your individual photos. So if you want to go for a colorful look, then it would only make sense to take photos in places with a lot of color. Or you could opt to take photos in places that have a lot of light shades. So that includes the streets, the sky, maybe a plain wall, anything as long as it's not dark. As you can see, most of the photos of her feed are very colorful. She would only take and post photos of things that she knew would contribute to her feed. Next, you'll need your clothes to match the kind of style you're going for. So I noticed that Ida's clothes are very solid, more plain, not a lot of prints. And this is good because when she's taking a photo with a busy background, it doesn't distract from the background. It also helps a lot if you have high quality photos for this. I think Ida uses a Fujifilm X-T2. With maybe a 35 or 50mm lens. The lens is how she gets her bokeh or like her blurry background shots. But if you don't have a fancy camera, that's fine too. You can always just use your phone. The most important thing is to make sure that your photos aren't super contrasted or super pixelated because you'll have a harder time editing it. Ida usually does her feed in this order. So close-up or face and then filler. Face, filler, face, filler. Even though her filler photos don't do as well in terms of likes and comments, I think they're still good for her because they contribute to her overall color scheme and feed. Before we go to the tutorial part of this video, I just want to thank everyone for all the positive feedback that you've given for my How to Edit Like Martine video, which is basically where this all started. I'm thinking of making this a series, so if you have any ideas or suggestions on whose style I should do next, leave a comment down below or you can DM me personally on Instagram. Now we go to the editing part of this video, which is basically why you all came. By the way, I'm going to be selling Ida-inspired presets that I made for each of the three videos that I'm going to post. And at the end of the three videos, I'm going to release an Ida collection, which will contain all the three presets for all the three separate videos. I tried my best to make them very affordable. You can get them through my Lazada shop, so you don't have to make it yourself on Lightroom. The link is in the description box. So if you want an easy, hassle-free, simple way to achieve her look, feel free to buy them. Otherwise, I'm just going to teach you guys how to edit these photos completely from scratch and teach you kind of basic Lightroom skills. Nothing very complicated or technical, so you can customize these to your own style as well. Please bear in mind that we're not gonna copy exactly how Ida does it. Ida uses her own Lightroom presets that she created, and until she spills her secrets, this is as close as we're gonna get for now. Now onto the technical side of things, we're only gonna be using Lightroom for this because it's hard to achieve this kind of look with visco filters. So I'm gonna show you how to edit this photo. First, we're gonna go to the light section. This is where you can correct the harshness for your photo so you end up with a nice base. So we're gonna press curves, and then we're gonna move the curves to something like this. We're gonna up the exposure a bit. We're gonna up the contrast a bit, put the highlights down. And then we're gonna put the shadows up so it's not too contrasted. We're gonna down the whites. And then we're gonna turn up the blacks. So as you can see, it's not as contrasted anymore. It's a bit brighter now. And then we're gonna go to the color section. This temperature tool is useful if you take indoor photos. If you took an indoor shot that tends to be kind of yellow, you can make it cooler, make it more blue so that it gets neutral again. The tint is for the white balance, like this. We're just gonna lower our vibrance a bit to maybe -5. But the most important part here is actually mix, which lets you isolate a specific color and adjust the tint of the color, how bright it is, how saturated it is. It basically allows you to create this unified palette. So for example, if I want my yellow top to match like the yellow wall, I could adjust the tint of the top to match the wall. So if you're wondering how bloggers can find places that exactly match their outfit, this is the secret. Red is usually where you adjust the lip color or the shadows of the skin. Orange is basically your skin tone. So if you want to look tanner or darker, you drag the luminance button down. And if you want to look kind of whiter or brighter, you drag the luminance up. We're gonna be adjusting the color of this. So for red, we're gonna drag the hue down, we're gonna drag the saturation up, and then we're gonna drag the luminance down. Now for orange, hue down, saturation down, and luminance down. For yellow, we're gonna drag the tint up and the saturation and the luminance down. For green, we're gonna adjust it to something like this, drag the saturation here and put the luminance down. For aqua, we're gonna adjust the hue kind of down, saturation down, and then we're not gonna touch the luminance. Lastly, for blue, we're gonna drag the hue up, saturation down, and luminance up. We're not gonna touch purples and pinks because you don't really see purples and pinks in this photo, so there's no point adjusting it. And then we're gonna go to effects, click split toning, so it allows you to adjust the color of the highlights and the colors of the shadows. We're gonna adjust the highlights to this, kind of an orangey tone, and then we're gonna press done. So as you can see, this is the before of the photo, and you can see after. It's more warm and vibrant, gives more of a summery look. What we're gonna do is press copy the setting, okay, click on the next photo, and then press paste. We're gonna go to color mix. So for reds, we're gonna drag the hue a bit more down. We're not gonna touch saturation or luminance. And then for orange, we're gonna drag the tint kind of upwards. Saturation down, luminance down. For yellow, we're gonna drag the tint all the way up. Make it more saturated, just a bit. We're gonna drag the luminance down to make it darker since my swimsuit is yellow. We're not gonna touch the greens because you don't really see greens in this photo. We're not gonna touch aqua either. For blue, we wanna adjust the color of the sky and the sea. So we're gonna drag the hue kind of upwards. And press done. Next, we'll go to split toning. So for highlights, we're gonna adjust it to something like this. And we press done. So you can see this is the before, and then this is the after. We're gonna repeat the process with the next photo. This one, press paste. Okay, exposure, we're not gonna touch that. Contrast, we're gonna drag it down just a bit. And that's it for the light section. Now we move on to color, go to mix. We're not gonna touch the reds. For oranges, we wanna adjust the skin tone of the people. So we're gonna drag the hue to something like this, drag the saturation here. We're not gonna touch yellow, green, or aqua, but we're gonna adjust the blues to something like this to make it more purpley. And we're gonna press done. I'm gonna show you before and after. Okay, next photo. For this photo, we're just gonna move the contrast down. And then we go to color mix, press blues, make it more saturated, and press done. And I think I wanna adjust my pants to make it more red and less orange, and decrease the saturation so it's not too colorful as before. And this is after. Now for our last photo, we're gonna decrease the contrast. Then we're gonna bring the highlights down all the way. We're gonna lessen the shadows just a bit. Then we're gonna bring the whites down, bring the blacks up so everything's brighter. Next, we go to color. For reds, let's bring the tint down just a bit. Now for orange, because I want my skin tone to be a bit more yellow, we're gonna drag it up to around 28. And then we're gonna make it more saturated. For yellow, we're gonna bring the tint up all the way. Then we're gonna decrease the luminance. We're not gonna touch green or aqua. But for blue, we're gonna adjust the hue up so that the sky is more purpley, so that it matches the overall theme. And then we're gonna bring the luminance down so it's not too bright. As you can see, the whites of this photo kind of got dark as we adjusted the luminance of the blue. And then we're gonna press done. Okay, so this is before and after. gonna show you the before and afters of the 5 photos that I edited. Now I'm gonna show you a comparison of my feed versus Ida's. There's really no formula to this preset. You kind of have to adjust it per photo and according to the color scheme that you want. Especially for the skin tone, sometimes the orange may be too saturated, so you're gonna have to bring the saturation down. Or sometimes the sky might be too dark blue, so you have to increase the luminance, meaning you have to make the sky brighter. You kind of have to be more strategic in editing this, so I suggest you pick a dominant color and then try to edit the colors of your photo to either match it or complement it. So for example, for her colorful feed, you can see there's a lot of lavender tones and a lot of green tones here. Ida is very strategic in how she templates the color, so the shades are usually the same color or at least similar. Now we're gonna talk about how to plan. Now I personally am not a crazy planner, but I do like to make sure that my feed looks at least well designed. I usually edit my photos in bulk and then I plan my content in advance so that I don't have to worry about it every day. I use an app called Unum. UNUM. I'm not sure how to say it. I say Unum. What it does is it allows you to look at your current feed, the photos you've posted, and the photos that you think about posting, and then you drag them around to see what order they look best in. Some other apps that you can use are Preview and Plan. They're all free apps. You can get them all in the App Store or the Play Store. And that is how it is done. That is how the magic is done. Again, if you don't want to bother with all the stuff that I taught you, my presets are for sale. You can buy them if you want, and then you can get an Ida feed in like 10 minutes tops. Otherwise, you can keep experimenting and keep practicing on Lightroom Mobile. Experiment with the colors and the lighting. I promise it's not that hard. It kind of looks intimidating, but it's not that hard. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram. My handle is @DanielleAllen. And I'll see you next time. Bye!